And finally, over to Haylon, who is speaking with Khosrow Salour, one of our Beachhead advisors in Iran.
This week, we're delighted to have Khosrow Salour with us. Khosrow is a business consultant based in Tehran and also an NZTE Beachhead advisor. Khosrow, many New Zealanders will know that Iran was fairly badly hit with the first wave of COVID infections. What's the current situation on the ground?
Haylon, thank you for having me. In March 3rd, Iran was ranked 3rd in the world as far as coronavirus-infected people is concerned. But right now, Iran is ranked 10th, and the growth rate of infected people has been reduced from 16% to 3%. Government shutdowns in many cities have been lifted. Especially this week, 132 counties were selected by the government to go into code white, which means that all the religious shrines and all the businesses that's been shut down up to this week are going to resume again. In other cities, bigger cities like Tehran or Mashhad or Qom, the shrines would still be closed, but the businesses and companies have gone back to resuming work since 2 weeks ago. But still in bigger cities, restaurants are closed and recreational businesses are closed and people follow social distancing. But also you have to notice that in Iran, the economy is based on a unrecognized sector or unmeasured sector, which is mostly related to vendors or people that do small transport. These sort of businesses have also resumed.
So what's the impact been for the economy overall? Has it been hit hard? And if so, what measures has the government put in place to mitigate these?
Sectors such as tourism, transportation, recreation, oil and gas, housing, banking, most of these sectors are observing negative growth. The low performance of oil income in the oil market have hurt the Iranian budget, which is much lower right now. And the effect of this is shown in government forecasts of around $30 billion of deficit for the current budget. You do see other effects in the economy as far as everyday people is concerned, and also small businesses. So the government is taking some direct measures to help stimulate the economy. The main incentive has been 4.4 billion euro in the shape of loans to companies and corporations, low interest loans. Also, there are other type of loans, low income persons, to small businesses. Direct payment to families is taking place. Tax exemptions and tax deadline extensions and VAT tax extensions has been put in place.
What may be a surprise to many listeners is that Iran's still a significant export market for New Zealand for humanitarian goods. Of course, that's not without challenges around sanctions and payment. But what's the current situation for exporters? Are there challenges with getting product to Iran being exacerbated by the current situation, or is it very much business as usual?
The main challenge has still been the U.S. sanctions. Although U.S. Treasury Department has allowed exports of humanitarian goods to Iran, but most of the international banks do not want to get involved in Iranian transactions. They're afraid to be fined by the U.S. Treasury Department. U.S. Treasury in April of this year has put out a directive specifically mentioning COVID-19 products as products that are exempted from current U.S. sanctions. The government itself is bringing about some incentives in order to facilitate trade. For example, all the COVID-19 products are exempted from tariffs. Also, a payment mechanism by European Union called Instex can be used for food and medical product exports to Iran.
Do you have any final comments for current New Zealand exporters to Iran?
It's always advisable for New Zealand companies to have a good marketing site for the products they want to trade in Iran. Also, due diligence on the buyer, on the source of payment, on the local companies involved in the transaction. Also, transparency in payment mechanisms used must be kept in mind. In many instances, the Iranian distribution network and supply chain uses old-fashioned methods, and some of the exporters can advise innovative measures in order to prevent waste in the supply chain. On a positive note, I wanted to emphasize on the fact that when COVID-19 resolves itself in Iran and the economy gets better, essential food and medical and pharmaceutical products must resume to be imported to Iran in a normal fashion.
Khosrow Salour, thank you very much for your insights on Iran this week.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Great. Thank you, Haylon and Khosrow.